Hi everyone, happy Monday. Welcome to a brand new week. So much fun to be with you guys. Hope you guys had a great, fantastic weekend. We had a wonderful weekend. We actually got to go out to Denver for about 4 days to see my family. I hadn't seen my parents from before COVID started, so we got to head out to see my mom and dad, to see the rest of my family. I don't know if you guys know, but I have 10 brothers and sisters, and most of them were there, aside from a few of them. So it was a really fun family gathering, and I actually got to hang out with my dad in his garden, which was really, really special. I posted a picture today over on Instagram, so you guys might want to head over and see a picture of my dad. He's in his 80s, and I actually learned to garden as a kid from he and my mom, and now he's growing a garden and learning from me. So it's really fun to be able to give back to him, hang out. We got to harvest some nice veggies. I got to help him prune up some of his squash and just do some things that he needed help with. So it was a ton of fun. So let me see here. I'm just going to refresh my computer here. I'm actually live streaming from the steps on my hill. So it's a little bit challenging setup, but I wanted to live stream by the little fall garden I planted on last week's video. It's really fun. I've already got some mustard greens coming up, which kind of surprises me because it's been a little bit warm. But they are popping through. The radishes haven't popped through yet. A little bit too warm for them, but I'm really glad to be with you guys today. Something else really exciting about the weekend before we get into our fall garden Q&A for the day is that I got to stop and visit, have a nice long visit with our moderator, Nisha. She lives in Denver now, and her husband are just fabulous people. So I got to stop at her house, see her new place. We've gotten to be good friends with her and her husband over the past couple of years, and she cooked an amazing lunch for us. She is an amazing cook, and we got to check out her new garden space and even film a video, which we're going to be bringing you hopefully within the next couple of days. So you guys are going to get to know her a little bit more. I just wanted you guys to put a face with the name here on our live stream. So thank you so much for Nisha for all your hospitality. We had a wonderful visit with them. So before we jump in, let's say hello to those of you that are here. We live stream every Monday, most Mondays at noon Pacific time. We're going to have a little bit different of a schedule in September, and I'll talk about that in just a moment. So Jan, yeah, big family, 7 girls, 3 boys. I'm third oldest. So I grew up taking care of all the younger kids. And, you know, we had to do a lot in the garden because we had a huge garden as a kid because we had such a big garden. And honestly, I wasn't in love with gardening as a kid because it was a lot of work. But as an adult, you know, you look back and you see those things from your childhood that you really enjoy, and you want to provide those experiences for your own family. Hi, Connie Graham. Great to see you from Oregon. Les Robot from Oregon as well. Edward, great to have you here today. Darlene, great to have you. Haven't seen you here for a while. Got down to 48 last night. Might hit 70 today. Only 66 at the moment, and my tomatoes aren't ripe yet. So keep an eye on that weather. If it frosts, you may want to go out there and cover those tomatoes up. Rachel, hi, how are you doing today? Great timing for the topic. My husband suggested carrots for my first fall garden. That's awesome, Rachel. We are going to be talking about carrots today. I pulled some questions from the YouTube video, last week's YouTube video on fall gardening. So we're going to be talking about some of those questions and then taking your questions live, of course, too. So if you guys haven't caught that video, head back and watch it. We kicked off the fall garden series with just kind of a general overview of fall garden, what vegetables you can plant, and then we planted up this little garden bed right behind me here. Great to have you here today. Sharon Osman Kobo, sowing brassicas, different carrots, greens, herbs, onions, and a daikon radish. How exciting. It's always good to have the variety in the garden. Tina, hello from Tennessee. Luz, how are you doing today? Starting seeds for fall garden. We'll see how successful we'll be, and hopefully you will. I know it can get hot where you live, but hopefully you'll get some cool weather and at least get some fall vegetables going. And hi, Debbie, how are you? Great to have you here. She is watching from Lanai off the coast of Maui in Hawaii. So great to have you. So before we jump into our Q&A today, let me make a couple of announcements about our September schedule. We're actually going on vacation for a couple of weeks in September. So looking forward to that, which means though we're going to be off, no live stream, the first 3 Mondays of September. So that would be Labor Day the 6th and the following 2 Mondays after that. That would be the 13th and the 20th. We'll be back to our regular live stream schedule on the 27th. So it'll be a long break, but we are going to fit in an extra Friday fireside live stream before the Friday before Labor Day. So that would be the 3rd of September, and that's going to be on Friday, September 3rd at 6 p.m. Camera guy's going to be there. A lot of you have might remember we did Friday firesides at the beginning of the pandemic, and it was really nice. We got to just have a more casual conversation and chat a little bit. Camera guy loved being on. A lot of you have requested that we do some more of those. So camera guy said, let's do another one so we can fit in one live stream before we go on vacation. So mark your calendars. Friday, September 3rd, 6 p.m. special live, 6 p.m. Pacific time, special live stream, and then no live streams the 6th, the 13th, and the 20th. So I know we'll have a big gap in there, but we'll get back to our regular live stream schedule after that. And then next week, regular live stream time, Monday Pacific time, I'm here at 15 minutes before the live stream starts to hang out in the chat, and our moderators are here a half an hour before the live stream starts. So join us, and a special welcome to the newcomers today. Appreciate you being here. We always have a good, good time. Okay, thank you so much, Yvonne. Love seeing y'all together in videos. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Camera guy always brings a fun element to the chat and to the videos, so I definitely couldn't do it without him. Thank you so much, Debbie, appreciate that. Okay, jumping right in here. We are going to jump into fall gardening. Now, I know for a lot of you, it's still pretty hot out. We're actually getting a couple of cool days here in Southern California, but many of you, I saw in the pre-chat, are already dipping down into the 70s and maybe the 40s and 50s at night. So it's really a perfect time to get out there and hopefully ripen up your tomatoes, cover them up if you're getting frost, but then sow some cool weather vegetable seeds. That's a great time to do it. If you're getting cool temperatures, you can plant them outdoors. If you're still in hot temperatures, try a few outdoors, but then you might want to start them inside under grow lights. So we're going to talk about a little bit more about that in just a moment. Okay, but definitely go back and watch when to start your fall garden and what to plant in any climate for kind of an overview of fall gardening. And then go ahead and watch the whole entire fall garden series from last year so that you can dig in and know exactly, you know, just a lot more details about what you can plant, how to plant it, etc., how to start from seed, and that kind of thing. So the fall garden series goes into a lot more detail. Okay, first question here is from Lynn Wong. And this was such a good question, actually, from last year's fall garden series that I wanted to pull it out and bring it to you guys today during the live stream and answer it again, because it's a great question. This is from Lynn Wong. And Lynn says, hi Kim, temp in Bay Area is getting cold. It drops under 40 tonight. Can we leave lettuce, spinach, and celery outside? I'm afraid it's too cold for the plants, so I put them in a mini greenhouse, but I wonder if I don't have to. Thanks. That is actually a really good question. A lot of people ask me that, is what is too cold for the cool weather vegetables? So cool weather vegetables are vegetables that do well under temperatures of 75 to 80 degrees, and many of them will even take light frost. Now, that doesn't mean they're gonna take a super hard freeze, but if you get those first few frosts of the winter time, a lot of them will do just fine. They'll freeze, they'll thaw out, and they will survive light frost very well. So 40 degree temperatures is just fine to leave them outdoors, no problem. The best thing is if they're pretty well established. Now, they're not gonna sprout real fast. If you're just germinating the seeds, they're not going to sprout real fast in 70 degree temperatures. Most cool weather vegetables will germinate in maybe like 50, 60 degree temperatures, 70 degree temperatures. They'll germinate very quickly. So if they're already, you know, growing, like my little fall seedlings are right here, these are, I think it's the Grand Rapids lettuce. Yeah, it's a Grand Rapids lettuce from the Fall Garden Seed Collection. It's been growing for about 2 weeks, doing very well. So this would be perfectly fine to leave outdoors. Now, they may not grow quite as fast at 40 degrees, but they're gonna be okay. They're not gonna freeze or die or anything like that. So absolutely, you can go ahead and leave them outside. And then the key with your fall vegetables is to get them established so that they do survive those light frosts. So you don't want to waste any time in starting your seeds, especially if you're in like mid to northern US or Canada. You want to get those seeds started right away so those vegetables, cool weather vegetables, get established. Now for southern climates, you still have a little bit of time. I always start my seeds early because I like to show you guys, you know, during the fall months when most people are in fall, how to grow them. But typically in a southern climate, your ideal time for growing fall vegetables is going to be November through, say, February. So, you know, you might have another couple of weeks and you want to start your seeds so that they're ready to plant the end of October, November, and you'll get some good production over the winter months. So thank you so much, Lynn. Really appreciate you asking that question. I know a lot of people also have that question as well. So hopefully that will help you as you kind of gauge, can I leave my fall veggies outside? Do I need to bring my new little seedlings indoors? And you do want to, if you don't have already, grab a copy of my book because I have a whole explanation in here. Chapter 2, let's see here, on cool weather vegetables. We've got a whole list of what the cool weather vegetables are. And then on the next couple of pages, what the warm weather vegetables are, so that you know kind of the guidelines for when they grow best, when they thrive, when you can get them started, that type of thing. So if you're not sure what those vegetables are and when you can grow them, grab this and it'll really help you out. Okay, so let's head into the chat here. And Max right in front of me. Let's head into the chat and find out what questions you have about fall gardening. But before I do that, let me just give you a little view of where I'm sitting. Now, when we were gone, the squash really got a lot of powdery mildew. So that's my job for tomorrow, is to get out and trim up some of those plants. But the sunflower forest is going crazy. And there's a little June, what are those called? The Japanese beetles up there. Those things are so aggressive. They have been flying at me whenever I come out, and they like to kind of fly at my hair. And now that I have curly hair, they kind of get stuck in it. So I'm waving my head and everything. So I don't know if the Japanese beetles in your garden are very aggressive, but they certainly are in mine. They don't bite, but they're just a little bit disconcerting. Okay, questions from the chat. I see Kathleen here. Kathleen Constantino. Hi, Kathleen. How's it going? And your question is, should I wait till temps decrease next week to direct sow? I would, you know, if your temperatures are going to be consistently like in the 80s, you know, you can go ahead and direct sow. And then as the temperatures cool off even more, your cool weather seedlings will start to germinate and grow a little bit faster. So you can plant them when your temps are hot, but they're just really not going to grow. And the most important thing is, like, if I put, let's see, I think I've got some radishes. Maybe they're back in the little seedling tray I have back there. But if you get those out there in the hot weather, plants like radishes and beets, they're not going to bulb up. They don't like the heat. You're going to get lots of leaves, but you won't get a lot of bulbs. So you just kind of want to gauge it. And I really like to wait till the temps are consistently in the 80s, in the 70s, and then get out there and direct sow. So this Japanese beetle is, woo, he's flying right by. Maybe you guys will get to see him. Okay, there he goes. Did you guys see him? Yeah, they get really aggressive. So just a little warning on that. Okay. Japanese beetles, says Edward, Japanese beetles are also annoying by the fact that they eat beans, grapes, and whatnot. Yeah, they like to chew little holes in your leaves here. But thankfully, we haven't had too much damage. Okay, Bing says, I got Japanese beetles and I never kill him. I just catch him in my hand and throw him as far as I can. I have one. I think it's the same one that comes every day. I think this one is too. We don't have a ton of them. But I do just see this one buzzing around, but I don't think I'm going to be catching him in my hand anytime soon. I'm not that brave, but definitely more power to you. I admire you if you can do that. Okay, let's see. What other questions do we have? Tanika, can I start radishes from seed? Here he comes again, guys. Woo! Oh my gosh. Can I start radishes from seed? Oh my gosh, he's flying right at me. Sorry, you guys. I had to swat him. He was coming right at my face. Can I start radishes from seed? Oh my goodness. This guy is not wanting to let go. He's actually landed on the tomato plant right next to me. And I think he thinks I'm trying to take over his plants. Okay, where did we go here? I think it was Terry asking about direct sowing radishes. You definitely, or not direct sowing radishes. You can definitely direct sow them, as I have right back here. I have started them from seed indoors before. I haven't always got the greatest results from that. They really don't like to be transplanted too much. So swat him good and hard, Rachel, yeah. No open hand grab being, I'm not doing that, sorry. You can start them from seed indoors, but you know what? They are so quick to grow. Most of the times you can get a harvest, depending on the variety, in 3 weeks, maybe 4 or 5 weeks. He wants to be famous too, how funny. And maybe 4 or 5 weeks. So you may just wanna wait till the temperatures are cool enough and get some planted outside. I like to start them inside just so I can show you guys what the leaves look like. And then you can plant them in the garden, and a lot of times those will be the radishes that I'll just get leaves from, not necessarily the bulb. So just kind of gauge accordingly. And like I always like to say, don't be afraid to experiment, get out there, maybe plant a little bit of both, direct seed, start some indoors, see how things work for you. And things work differently in different climates. So just do whatever you prefer. Okay, Alice, thanks for the warning. They can bite. One bit my two-year-old when he picked him up. Oh my goodness, I actually thought that they couldn't bite. So maybe there's different varieties that bite and that kind of thing. Okay, let's see here. What other questions do we have? Hindi360, how are you doing today? How should I prepare the container soil for carrots, please? Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go ahead and read the next question and then we'll talk a little bit more about carrots because a lot of people have been asking about carrots. So the next question is from Marilyn, and she asks, she made a comment on last week's fall garden video. Hi Mac, he can't get through because I'm sitting on his little step that he usually goes through on. So Marilyn says, I know you're talking to people all over the place with different climates. For your climate, when do you start carrots? I'm between inland and coastal San Diego. According to Farmer's Almanac, we should start in September. But I can't wait. I will keep the container in part shade and possibly add shade cloth. This month, the weather hasn't been as hot. Okay, so carrots are a cool weather vegetable. And like I've mentioned about cool weather vegetables, they like temperatures of 80 degrees or lower. The great thing about carrots is get them growing now while the temperatures aren't too hot. And when they start to develop and grow and reach their full size, you can actually leave them in the ground until you're ready to pick them. So once it gets really cold, you want to mulch them very heavily. And then you can harvest as you please. Now, if you get super hard frosts and hard freezes and your ground freezes solid, you probably do want to go out and harvest them before that happens so that, you know, you can actually use them during the winter time. But like California, I can pull them out as I need them. You know, milder winter climates, you can do that too. They keep very well in the ground for a long time. So I usually plant mine for the best production and the best growth. I'd say probably the beginning of October. The temperatures will be cooling off probably towards the end of the month. And the thing about carrots is that you do want to, I love to plant them in a container. I think they just grow better there. The soil is nice and loose. There's not really any special preparation needed for the container aside from, you know, just a potting mix. If it's potting mix you've used before, make sure you refresh it by adding some compost, some worm castings, a couple inches of fresh potting mix. But the seeds do need to be kept moist. Until they germinate. Don't let the top of the soil dry out. So typically what I'll do is cover the top with a piece of shade cloth to keep the water in. Very, very lightly mulch with some fine material like shredded up leaves. Don't mulch too heavily or they're gonna have a tough time poking through. But make sure that you keep that water moist. And then keep them moist, you know, as they're growing and forming the carrots. And then when they get to be just a couple inches tall, you wanna thin out the little seedlings to give room in the container for the carrots to grow to their full size. But I do have a couple of videos on growing carrots, so for more information on that, you wanna go back, and the links are in the video description of this live stream, and Cliff or Nisha will pop that in the chat here too. But if you're looking for carrot seeds, please grab a couple seed collections that they're in, is the Fall Garden Seed Collection. And if you need any cool weather seeds, grab this. It has 13, 14 maybe, I think, varieties of cool weather vegetables. So I really designed my seed collections to make it easy for you to get started. If you're busy and you don't want to go hunt down a bunch of fall seeds, or if you're new and you have no idea what are cool other vegetables, I've made it easy for you by putting together lots of different seed collections, but the fall garden one is great for this time of the year. And also, carrots are in the kids garden seed collection, which are seeds that are particularly suited for kids growing. They grow fast, they're colorful, and kids really enjoy growing with that collection. So grab those two collections if you are in need of some carrot seeds. And just for the live streamers today, you guys, didn't announce this anywhere else, I really wanna thank you guys for joining me on Monday so faithfully. So I have a special discount code for you to use today to get 15% off everything on my website, all the seed collections, the Cali Kim Smart Pots, my book. So the code for 15% off is livestream over at calikimgardenandhome.com. And I'm actually extending that sale. Usually they just run till Monday, but it's gonna go till Tuesday this week to give you guys a chance to pick up some fall seeds, some containers. The Cali Kim 1 gallons are a really fun container to grow in. These are great for indoor gardening, which we'll be starting the indoor garden series soon, for microgreens, for lettuce, for herbs. There's all kinds of things you can grow in those. And I don't know where I put my little microgreen container somewhere. Oh, here it is. I actually started some microgreens in an almond milk container on my windowsill last week, but pretty soon we'll be starting some in the 1 gallon. So microgreens are a great thing to grow during the winter. Whoops, this one got smashed. During the winter, if you don't think you can grow anything outside or don't necessarily want to. Okay, Jackie says, first time growing cool weather veggies. Jackie, welcome. So glad that you're here. It's really fun to start a fall garden. And a lot of people think that the only time you can grow is in the summertime, but the fall is actually a really pleasant time to grow. It's nice and cool outside. And that way you can kind of, you know, shake things up a little bit if you're getting tired of all the tomatoes and cucumbers and the squash and everything else you've been harvesting all summer. It's a nice way to get a little bit of variety in your diet and on your dinner plate, and grow things like lettuce. The mustard, red mustard greens are coming up behind me, the radishes, the cabbages, the broccoli, cauliflower, etc. Okay, so let me jump into the chat and answer your questions about fall gardening before we jump back to some of the other ones from YouTube. Okay, let's see here. Maxine Toller, in Southern California, can I plant a second crop of scarlet runner beans? Absolutely, you definitely can. Scarlet runner beans are so, so quick to grow. And the ones I've grown this year have been just incredible. They've gone crazy. Let me see if I can show you guys. But usually you can get a harvest in about 6 to 8 weeks. I have some growing on this arch behind me. I don't know if you guys can see that. I had to trim them back a few weeks ago because it was so overgrown I couldn't even walk through. The arch was falling over. And then right here, I can't see what I'm pointing my camera at here. There's some on a trellis growing over a hanging basket and just kind of taking over that area, but we're getting a ton of beans off them. They grow so fast. They actually love a little bit cooler of a temperature. They're doing great in this spot because they're partially shaded from the hot summer, but plant them now in the full-on sun and you should be able to get a crop within about 8 weeks before, you know, cooler weather hits here in Southern California. A question from Hindi about carrots. Would a 1 gallon container be fine for carrots? You know what? I wouldn't recommend these for carrots. They're just a little bit too small. You might be able to plant one or two short carrots in here if you have a really short, small variety. But really the 5 gallon, like the one I have right back there, would work best. I also have the 5 gallons in the vibrant colors, in the orange, the purple, and the berry blue. So now's a good time to grab those with the special discount. But yeah, I would recommend a 5 gallon or the little purple mini raised bed, which you can also grab with the kids garden seed collection. Also works great for carrots too. It's about maybe a foot tall and it's got 3 square feet of growing space, and I've grown carrots in that many times and it works really well. Okay, Shan Ratha Augustus says, is it too late to start cucumbers for Northern California in zone 9B? And let me see, I think my next question might have to do with that. You know what? Hold on to that question for just a moment, because actually I do have a question, an is it too late question coming up in just a few minutes here, and we'll get to your question then. Okay, so next question from the Fall Garden YouTube video over from last week is from Italian Bionda. Can I start seeds in small pots without grow lights, but outdoors? It's August and I live in the Northeast. Thanks, I have your book and your fall seed collection. So thank you so much, Italia, first off. I really appreciate you growing along with me with my book and fall garden seed collection. Really appreciate your support of our small business. We're a family-owned business, so that's great, awesome that you're supporting us. I really appreciate that. And you absolutely can start your seeds in small pots without grow lights, but outdoors. So the key is make sure the temperature is right. You wanna go back and watch, we did a video maybe a month ago or so about what to plant in July. And I showed you my outdoor seed starting station. And I planted some seeds outdoors, just set them on a shelf on the side of my house, no grow lights. And those are warm weather vegetables because it was warm at the time I planted them. And they did just fine. I planted several of them out in the garden. They're just flourishing and doing just fine. Grow lights are helpful at this time of the year, well, at many times of the year, but at this time of the year for cool weather vegetables, if you live in a climate where it's say 80, 90 on up degrees, because cool weather vegetables are not gonna grow or thrive in those types of temperatures. So really depends on the temperature and the type of vegetable that you are planting. So here what I always try and present is principles of gardening, such as cool weather vegetables versus warm weather vegetables, kind of explain what those are. And then you can decide what time is right to plant them in your climate depending upon the weather. So if you want to definitely want to know when your first and last frost date is, that's always an important date for a gardener. And that can be found on almanac.com. I'll have a link in the video description. So keep an eye on the weather and do a little bit of research as to what the average temperatures are in your area at the different times of the year that you're going to be planting. So, and I believe that's probably on almanac.com also. If not, you can just Google it. It's probably on weatherchannel.com or something like that. There's lots of resources out there to kind of figure out the average temperatures in your area so you can kind of plan when you want to plant what type of vegetables. So kind of follow along with those principles, adjust for your climate, and you should be good to go. Okay, so, oh, I also wanted to offer you guys a resource. We're all about sharing tips, tricks, help making your garden experience that much better, and sharing resources too. So I've used a lot of different products in my garden, a lot of different things that work, some things that don't work, the seeds that work, the seeds that don't work, and I always like to recommend ways that you can save money and try things that work. So putting together, talking again about the fall garden, I put together a bundle. So when you purchase the fall garden seed collection and the book, you'll see on my website, there's something called the garden seed bundles. There's a whole bunch of these paired with different seed collections. When you purchase the products as a bundle, you can save money. For example, this one is $5 when you purchase it as a bundle, as opposed to purchasing them separately, it would be $5 more. And when you pair it together with a discount code, you save even more. So look for those items on my website. That way you can save money and, you know, have more money to spend on other things. Okay, so let's jump back into the chat here. See what other questions you have going. And this is a question from Holy Nation for Life. I live in Chicago. Do you know what I can grow from seed during this time? Yeah, you would want to go back and check our videos on fall gardening. Those are all the cool weather crops. And then planting a late summer garden, or what to plant in July. Those are some warm weather crops, and those two videos will give you some ideas as to what you can plant this time of the year. You definitely want to get some quick growing warm weather crops going if you have enough time for that, and those videos will give you some guidelines. Okay, let's see here. Let's scroll down and find a couple other questions here. Okay, Terry, how are you doing? Question, I like purple carrots. Does your collection have a variety of carrot colors? The fall garden, I believe, let me just check. Sometimes it depends on what seeds I have available, but this one I believe has the purple carrot. And I know the kids' garden for sure has the purple carrot. I might have planted the ones from this particular envelope. Let's see here. I must have planted the carrot seeds so they're not in here. But let me see. I believe it does have the purple carrots. Those are usually the ones that I carry, but just check on the website. I don't have a carrot seed collection as of yet. So if that's something you're interested in, let me know and we can see what we can do about that. Okay, Mitzi Webb says, my herbs have been overwhelming growing. That's awesome. So you can get out there and harvest your herbs. If you have tons of basil, you can make some pesto, but it's always fun to have tons and tons in the garden. That's always a tough problem to have, right? Okay, Luz says, can I start purple sprouting broccoli in Southern California 10B? You'd probably want to start them indoors at this point. So go back and watch last week's fall garden video. I show you how to do that. And watch last year's fall garden series for step-by-step instructions on how to start from seed. Okay, let's move into our next question. And that is from D. And this question was, is it too late to start zucchini from seed in zone 10B in Southern California? So it kind of goes along with what we were just talking about as far as, you know, teaching you guys or sharing with you guys garden principles of cool weather vegetables and warm weather vegetables. But really a key to this is you want to know your dates to maturity. And what that means is, for example, zucchini, if you start from seed today, it will have, under ideal conditions, warm weather, temperatures between, say, 60-ish degrees at night on up to 95, 100 degrees during the day. Usually takes about 60 days to go from seed to harvest. So 60 days is the date to maturity. So what you want to do when you're looking at a vegetable and saying, is it too late to plant this vegetable in this part of the world? That's probably one of the questions I get the most. What you want to do is look at the dates to maturity and look at the type of vegetable that it is. Is it a cool weather vegetable? Is it a warm weather vegetable? Do you have enough time of the weather being the ideal, you know, not necessarily ideal, but you know, those warmer temperatures or the cooler temperatures to get a harvest before the temperatures kind of shift? So zucchini, if you live in zone 10B, which is probably somewhere in the way south of the US, most likely you do have about 60 days of warm temperatures left. So that's always two things that you wanna look for: dates to maturity, the type of vegetable it is, and then do you have enough time? I guess that's three things. Do you have enough time to get a harvest, you know, before the vegetable in the dates to maturity zone there? Keeping in mind too, those dates to maturity are under ideal conditions. There's Mac right back there. He figured out another way to get up to the top. Those dates to maturity are under ideal conditions. So, you know, we're gonna be getting less hours of sunlight over the next several weeks as we move more into the fall. So, you know, your vegetables may not grow quite as fast if they're in a shaded location and not getting, you know, their full 6 to 8 hours to 10 hours of sunlight, they're not gonna grow as fast. So you always wanna keep those things in mind and just kind of gauge. Those are always kind of general, that's kind of a general time frame. But don't be afraid to experiment, try something. You know, if your zucchini, if you don't get a harvest, then all you have lost is a couple of seeds, planted some seeds, and you know, it's worth the experiment, and then you'll make a little note on your calendar to start a little bit earlier next year. Okay, so hopefully that helped you out there to kind of generally plan for when you can start your seeds and get a harvest. Okay, let's see here. Other questions in the chat. And here we have a great comment from Debbie. Love this, Debbie. I'm learning to embrace the things that grow well here on Lanai. I always want to be able to grow things that don't do well with our warm, humid weather. I love that, Debbie, because you know what? Sometimes, you know, we might want to grow things that just really aren't meant for your area or for your climate. So absolutely, instead of getting frustrated that you're not able to grow lettuce in your climate because it's consistently above 80 degrees, lettuce is not going to thrive there. Pick another type of green that will thrive in your climate, like kale, like chard, maybe some more heat tolerant varieties of lettuce in the wintertime when it gets a little bit cooler, red mustard greens, those types of things, and just embrace the things that do well in your area. And I would highly recommend that you ask around to other gardeners if you're not sure what grows well in your area. Ask around at maybe those local garden centers if you have any of those. They're usually very knowledgeable there. Or, you know, jump on the Gardening Coast to Coast Facebook group. tons of people there, and find some people in your area that can help you figure out what grows well. So great comment, Debbie. Thanks so much for sharing. It's always good to experiment and then go with what works and what you enjoy. And speaking of gardening coast to coast, guys, very exciting. The new podcast should be starting up the first week of September. Gary and I have already recorded our very first episode last week. The website is under construction. You can go and check it out at gardeningcoasttocoast.net. And we are recording our second episode on Wednesday. So hopefully we'll have two in the can before the end of the week. So it's definitely happening. And go ahead and head over to gardeningcoasttocoast.net. Send in a question. There's a form there that you can click on, a space you can click on. Send in a question. You never know. You might get your question read during our podcast and answered. And we're even considering maybe doing some special podcast episodes, Q and A's of questions that we get via our website. So please go check it out. We cannot wait to bring it to you. It's going to be a ton of fun. Okay, so let's jump here back into the chat and see what questions you might have. I did see a question scroll by a few minutes ago, about strawberries and how to prepare your strawberries for the winter. So strawberries are very cold tolerant. They are a perennial. So usually they have great production for about 3 to 4 years before they start to kind of, you know, die off a little bit and just produce that much less. But for the winter time, what you want to do is once they go dormant or the leaves start getting a little bit crispy, you want to, or crispy or just kind of dying off, you want to cut them back to just a couple of inches above the crown and then heavily mulch them with shredded leaves, with straw, with pine needles to insulate the roots, because you don't want the roots getting too terribly cold, and once the roots die, the plants die. So do that. If you're, you know, if they're in a garden bed, you might want to cover them definitely with a few inches of mulch. If they're in a container, you can mulch your containers heavily. If you can, move your container to a more sheltered location, up against your house, maybe up against a stone wall where it'll get a little bit of heat, maybe residual heat, and then cover them with some type of a winter covering like a frost blanket, a piece of plastic. That's if you live in a climate where you get you know, heavy frosts and hard freezes. If you live in a southern climate, you really don't need to do much, but cover them with some mulch, and they may die back during the winter. You might get a few berries, but all in all, they're gonna survive just fine. Okay, let's see here. Elizabeth, hello, can you tell me what can I start planting now for fall harvest? Okay, Elizabeth, you must have joined our live stream late, but you wanna go back and watch the fall garden series videos, and it'll tell you all about that. There's tons of cool other vegetables that'll be great to plant right now. So go back and watch those for all of the details. Okay, let's see here. Anne Reeves, same to you, Anne. I live in Los Angeles. What can I start from seed right now? So yeah, go back and watch the live stream. I just shared like how you can figure out what you can plant now based on where you live. So follow those principles and you will be good to go. You should be able to get a couple more crops of maybe beans and some cucumbers here in the Los Angeles area. Okay, let's see here. Angela has a question. I went into my garden yesterday and found some very small holes in the dirt of my eggplant. Continued to look and they were tiny like pinworms. Do you know what they are and how to get rid of them? Okay, not too sure what they are. So you might want to figure out what they are first. If they're a bad insect that's not beneficial, there's lots of different things that you can do. It's always good to have a couple of different methods in your back pocket for insect control. So one thing I've used for years is a combination of neem oil, peppermint oil, and rosemary oil. That works very well. I've got a video on that. So just look up organic pest control and that video should pop up. This year I've been using a lot of the Bonide products. Really like them because they work very quickly. There's lots of organic options. The dead bug spray is a great one. The insecticidal soap is great for powdery mildew, and it also helps control a lot of the garden pests. So there's links for all the product, the Bonide products that I use in the video description. You can treat the soil with that. You can treat the leaves with that, but you always want to test spray whenever you're bringing a new spray into your garden, or even when the temperatures are hot versus cool, you want to test spray. I like to spray in the morning, not in the bright sunlight, before the bee activity is heavier, and that way you keep the bees safe as well. Okay, let's see here. One more question is from ColorMe77. How do you store leaves from fall for summer mulch? Can you just store them outdoors in a bag? And this question was left, I believe, on the fall garden video from last week. And the question is, yes, they are super easy to store. I love to collect leaves. Once the fall comes, we get tons of windy weather and the leaves just blow off the trees. My neighbors, friends will save them for me. And you can just collect them in black plastic garbage bags. You can even wet down the garbage bags and poke holes in them, stick them in the sun, and it'll help the leaves break down a lot quicker so that you can actually use them for leaf compost. Now, a little tip with leaves is before you put them in a garbage bag, another way I like to collect them before I get to that is in the Smart Pots compost sack. If you guys have watched any of my composting videos, you know that I love to compost in the compost sack. It's a humongous, I think it's 100 gallons, compost sack made out of the same Smart Pots material that they make all of their containers out of. And it's a nice way to keep your leaves or your compost contained. You can purchase a cover that fits over the top so it keeps the critters out. It makes a great hot compost pile, but also a great bin for collecting your leaves. But what you can do is with your black garbage bags or your compost sack is you can, number one, shred your leaves if you can with your lawnmower. Just lay them out on your lawn, run over them with the lawnmower, because the smaller your leaves are, the quicker they're gonna break down, either in your compost or on your garden beds. So stick them in that garbage bag or the compost sack, shred them first, and then rinse them, but wet them down to help them break down even faster. This is all, of course, optional. If you don't have a lawnmower, don't worry about it. Just throw them in the sack. If you don't want to water them down, just throw them in the sack and save them till next year. So just do the methods that work best for you. But that's what I have found helps things break down quicker. So a great thing to do is collect leaves over the winter time and put them on your garden bed. So we've got a bunch of videos that will pop in the video description on what you can do with leaves and all the beneficial things about leaves for your garden. Here comes our Japanese beetle friend again. Okay, Linda Sopp. Yes, we did just cover that. So go back and watch the live stream. It does replay, upload as a replay, or go back and watch last week's fall video. Make sure that you guys do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon because we're uploading videos 2 to 3 times a week usually. And that way you don't miss the uploads, you get all the information, and that way you get your questions answered quickly. So I get a lot of emails with questions and I try and get back to people, but it takes me a while sometimes and I just can't get back to everyone. But a lot of times those questions are answered in my videos. So go on our channel, there's a little magnifying glass where you can type in what your question is, not necessarily what your question is, but what vegetable you have a question on. A lot of times we'll have a video on it, and that way you can get your question answered quickly if I can't get back to you. So that will be very, very helpful for you guys. Okay, Cliff, yes, we will have to talk garlic sometime soon. I plant last week of September in a four-season climate, and I love that term, four-season climate. That's a great term, Cliff. I may have to borrow that from you. But generally, you do want to plant a couple of weeks before your last frost date, 3 to 4 weeks maybe, 2 to 3 weeks, sometime in that time frame, so that your garlic has a chance to kind of settle in, get established there before the frost hits. But it does go dormant during cold weather. In California, we have a tough time in a warm winter climate. We have a tough time getting large garlic bulbs because it does like that period of cold winter dormancy, but you still can plant it. Usually if I plant garlic, I plant it probably November-ish would be a good time. But I have a couple videos on that, which you can find over on our YouTube channel. Yeah, he does. Let's see here, a couple other questions. Okay, thank you so much, Jan. Kevin at Epic Gardening did a video on garlic, which he also just harvested. Awesome, thank you so much. So go over and check out Kevin's channel as well over at Epic Gardening. Okay, great comment here from Drummer Loves Bookworm. I'm desperate to create an indoor herb garden to go all winter. Help, I cannot give up copious fresh herbs. I am right there with you. I love fresh herbs. They add so much flavor to your food, and it's really hard to be without them when you've gotten used to them all summer. And you definitely can grow herbs indoors. So to give you a little bit of help on that one, go back and watch last year's indoor garden series. I cover how to grow herbs indoors. So you get a lot of good information there. And we will be starting indoor garden series, I don't know, maybe October-ish. So that will be coming up. These, as I mentioned a little bit earlier, these 1 gallon Calicum Smart Pots are great for your indoor garden. They work beautifully for herbs. And I also have an indoor garden seed collection with a couple of herb varieties in that as well. So you can go over to my website, check that out, and then check out the indoor garden series from last year. But we'll have new content on that coming out soon. Okay, let's see here. A couple more questions. Holy Nation for Life, is there a book that helps figure out what seed varieties grow best for the area where you live? That's a good question. I don't know of one specifically that says specific varieties for the specific area where you live. So you just have to do a little bit of research on that and ask around at your local garden centers. But this one does give a general overview of cool weather versus warm weather vegetables, if you're wondering about that. But again, follow the general principles of gardening. And then you probably will just have to do some research as to what specific varieties grow best in your area. Okay, let's see here. One more question. Let me try and find someone's question that I haven't answered yet. Hi there, Irene. Hi, Kim. How much neem oil to use just for a spray bottle? And does neem oil expire? Irene, I don't remember the exact ratio for a spray bottle. Of course, it depends how big your spray bottle is. But you want to go back and check out the organic pest control video, because you can find a recipe in that video, and then you can make adjustments depending on how many ounces your spray bottle is. Does neem oil expire? You know what? It has a very long shelf life. I've had some for several years that I still use. Once you mix it up, though, you do want to use it probably, I'd say, within 24 hours. But as far as the concentrate, I'm not aware that it has an expiration date. So yeah, I think you're probably good to go on that. Okay, guys, what a fun live stream today. Thanks for being such a great group. Great to have you here. Again, don't forget the 15% off sale for you guys as a special thank you for being here with the code LIVESTREAM over at calicumgardenandhome.com. And be looking for a video featuring Nisha, yes, our very own Nisha, in her garden coming up in the next couple of days, and another fall gardening video sometime this week or on Saturday. We usually post midweek and on the weekends, and then we have our Monday live stream. So thanks a lot for joining us, and hope you guys have a great week. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.